the first car to show up was a Scirocco, but then shortly afterwards we got the first Golf. But back then we called it a Rabbit. The first Golf was set to achieve certain objectives because, remember, it was following what was then an icon and is still an automotive icon today, the Beetle. This car was designed, basically, the first Golf to replace the Beetle. And today we're here with what is the seventh generation.
The GTI will be available in our dealerships in the month of June, and I know customers are anxiously awaiting that. But it is just the beginning of the rollout of the Golf family this calendar year and into next, continuing with the other powertrains of Golf, going into our e-Golf, our first battery electric offer, in the end of calendar year 14, followed by the Golf R, which is coming as part of this life cycle, not 3 years from now, like we've done with previous generations, and then following with the Golf Sportwagon. For the first time ever, an import brand received Japan Car of the Year. The Golf, when you compare it, you've heard us say it's longer, it's wider, it's more spacious. These characteristics are proven in the numbers. I mentioned the alternative powertrains because we are working towards the future where we also need to bring fully electric vehicles to market. In detail, let's talk about the 1.8 TSI. This is our third generation of our EA 888 engine family with the 1.8. It produces 170 horsepower and has 200 pound-feet of torque. The TDI Clean Diesel is the newest generation with our EA 288 powertrain. It now produces 10 more horsepower than the outgoing TDI at 150 horsepower, and it has 236 pound-feet of torque. We see as the major competitors the Ford Focus ST and the Honda Civic Si.